In a previous video, we went through Rachel Green's growth scan report, and some of you may have noticed that the report notes a low-lying placenta. For this video, we're going to talk about placenta previas, low-lying placentas, and what that means in pregnancy. The placenta, commonly known as the afterbirth, is attached to the womb and provides baby with oxygen and nutrition via the umbilical cord. It can be attached at the front wall of the uterus, on the sides, or at the back of the womb. A placenta previa describes an afterbirth that is covering the entrance to the womb, which we call the internal cervical os, while low-lying placenta is any placenta that is attached to the lower part of the womb, and the edge of that placenta is less than 20 millimeters away from the os. If you're a nerd like me, then this is how it would look like on a Venn diagram, which means that all placenta previas are low-lying placentas, but not all low-lying placentas are placenta previas. It is thought that placenta previas affect about 1 in 200 pregnancies at term. Although low-lying placentas can happen in any pregnancy, there are factors which will increase the chance of its occurrence. They include women who require fertility treatment to become pregnant, women who are older and those who smoke during the pregnancy, as well as women who've had previous cesarean births. Indeed, the risk of placenta previa increases with the number of cesarean births a woman has. The commonest way we identify a low-lying placenta is when a parent is having an anomaly scan at around 20 weeks of the pregnancy. If the placenta appears low, we may consider an internal scan, during which the ultrasound probe is inserted vaginally, as this will give us greater accuracy compared to a scan through the tummy. If you've had a previous cesarean birth and the placenta appears both low and at the front of the womb, we will also be checking to see if the placenta has invaded through the scar of the womb, which we call a placenta accreta, and this carries greater risk to both mum and baby, especially during birth. Should you be concerned with a low-lying placenta? The main concern is bleeding, therefore we ask women with a low-lying placenta to be extra vigilant with vaginal bleeding. We ask that you avoid intercourse or any sexual activity which can lead to an orgasm, as this is associated with transient tightenings of the womb, which can provoke bleeding. We also recommend avoiding strenuous exercising or heavy lifting, as this is associated with preterm births. If you notice vaginal bleeding, you need to seek help. In most cases, it's reasonable to contact your maternity unit, as you will likely be asked to attend for a review. If you're bleeding heavily, for instance, blood is appearing through your trousers or running down your legs, or if you're starting to feel dizzy or about to pass out, please contact an emergency number for an ambulance so that you can be assessed urgently. If the bleeding is light but ongoing, we would advise remaining in hospital until the bleeding has settled for a period of time, as we are concerned the bleeding may suddenly become heavy, which may require urgent intervention such as a C-section to safeguard the well-being of both mum and child. While you're being monitored in hospital, we advise that you have a cannula, as it provides us with quick access to give IV medications in an emergency. If the bleeding happens between 24 to 36 weeks of the pregnancy, we may consider giving steroid injections, especially if the chance of going for a cesarean section is high. This reduces the chance of breathing difficulties, infections, and bleeding into the brain, which tend to happen with premature babies. If your blood type is rhesus D negative and your baby is predicted to be rhesus D positive, you will be offered an NTD injection for every new episode of vaginal bleeding. Reassuringly, the majority of women with low-lying placentas will not experience vaginal bleeding during the pregnancy. Routinely, we will perform an ultrasound scan at around 32 weeks, as only 1 out of 10 women who were diagnosed earlier will have a low-lying placenta remaining at term. This is because the lower part of the womb stretches as the pregnancy progresses, therefore shifting the position of the placenta. If the placenta is high and there are no ongoing concerns with the pregnancy, you will carry on with your care with the midwives. However, if the placenta remains low, you will be offered a scan at 36 weeks to confirm the location of the placenta and to plan for birth. In cases of placenta previa that is persistent, we will schedule an elective cesarean section, as laboring will put both mum and baby at risk due to heavy blood loss. Your obstetrician will discuss with you when to schedule the elective cesarean birth. If you've not had any bleeding, we would typically schedule this at around 37 weeks of the pregnancy. In some instances, especially if you've had multiple attendances for vaginal bleeding, we may schedule this sooner. It's important to know that a cesarean section due to a placenta previa is a high-risk procedure. Therefore, the staff members are all appropriately trained and are ready to manage any complications that may occur, and they will take steps to minimize blood loss. If the bleeding is heavy, there's a high chance of needing a blood transfusion or removal of the womb, which we call hysterectomy. But this is only done if all other measures to control the bleeding have been unsuccessful. If it isn't a placenta previa, but the placenta remains low, your obstetrician will discuss with you your birth options. In most cases, we will still recommend an elective cesarean section. However, if baby's head is lower than the placental edge on scan, we can consider a vaginal birth. A systematic review published in 2019 looked at women who labored with a low-lying placenta. It showed the chances of a vaginal birth versus an emergency cesarean section during labor varies depending on the distance between the os and the placental edge. If the distance was greater than 10 mm, the chances of a vaginal birth was around 85%. Among the groups, it also showed no difference in the number of women who needed a blood transfusion, as well as the number of women who had a postpartum hemorrhage. So this is it for low-lying placenta and placenta previa. Give this video a like if you found this helpful, share and subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you again soon.